Hi guys, welcome back to my channel for Final Fantasy Brave Exvius video. In this video, I will try to challenge this Corn of Ymir on the Chamber of Indignant on the advanced difficulty. And this Ymir is the first boss of Final Fantasy 6. And this is the mission here. Complete the quest, we get Man Eater Sense. Clear without an ally being KO, energy restore 50x10. Clear within 10 turns, we get STMR exchange ticket X5, and party 5 or less we get rare summon ticket. So I already make the video for Scorn of Ymir before, but I already delete it just because they already fixed the trial, so I will explain it later. So I will take this companion. This companion Noctis also with combined with mine, so with mine cobalt blade Noctis, so he gear up. Is very good for the killer. So on the normal form it doesn't matter. On his brave shift form, this is the most important thing. And let's check for the equipment with double ultima blade, and then for STMR and also jump damage boost and also Aquan killer. So let's check it out for this Noctis. Max out through dual wield attack, 150% of physical aquatic killer and 750% jump damage boost. So the jump damage boost mine is better. So this is my Cobalt Blade Noctis, exactly almost the same. For normal form is not too important. On his brave shift form, he's geared up like this. This is my main DPS. So my Cobalt Blade Noctis makes out through dual wield attack with 150% of physical aquatic killer and 800% of jump damage boost. So I need to mention for my Noctis, I equip my Bahamut here. So I have this break damage boost. This will boost physical attack damage by 50% against enemy under break status. So this is my another unit. So for Shoreline, Fina, and Daisy, make sure on their normal form, their normal form are above 100% of fire, ice, lightning, and wind. So this is my Shoreline, Fina, and Daisy. On normal form, make sure to equip this Genji shield for nullify the instant KO or the instant death attack. And this is some LB fill and also lots of elemental resistance. On their brave shift form, we start with this form for filling LB, for filling Esper gauge, and also this field system has 100% defense and spirit boost in the beginning of battle. For miracles shoes, we get auto protect, auto shield, and auto regen. So for wing recovering suit, we get agility here. As for evade one physical attack. Yep, I think that's all. Next, for Gilgamesh, we start on his brave shift form using double spear for breaking the gauge, breaking the break gauge on the Ymir shell. So that's all for my Gilgamesh on his brave shift form. So on the normal form, he will be the SR chain with Mazurka to land out Noctis with the chaining, the SR chain. So this is my Gilgamesh. So max out of the attack and max out of physical aquatic killer. So sorry for the bad voice, just because heavy rain on my house. Next for Mazurka for breaking using the double spear, for breaking the gauge on Ymir shell and also healing our party using Lakshmi, and then SR chain with Gilgamesh. So I think that's all for my party, and let's go to our fight. So enemy strike first, hide in the shell, it covers the body. That's the preemptive attack, they already fix it. Since when the this trial release, they this Ymir didn't do the preemptive attack. So this mean on the turn 1, this Ymir will attack our party. Unlike on the previous day, since this trial already been fixed. So let's start the battle here. So for Gilgamesh, let's use triple hero. Let's break using Secret Sword Art Excalibur. This will break 85% of all stats, and also the spear. This one Secret Art Spearless Spear. Let's target to Ymir body first, and then change to shell. Yes, let's check for the body. Already been break on the shell. Yes, so for Mazurka, triple emotion, double edge spear drive to the shell. Nice. So for Shoreline Vina and Daisy, let's revert back to their normal form. Double C magic. Let's provoke using splash fight. This will this magic damage dealt by aquatic monster by 20%. So this will be the best choice for this fight. And then Lagoon Shell. So for Cobalt Blade Noctis, let's go to his Prefshi form, triple ability, Omega Charge, Omega, Return to Dawn, and Warp Strike. Let's target to the shell first. For the other Noctis, let's go doing the same. Go to Prefshi form, triple ability, Omega, Little Down Warp Light to the Ymir body. So since we there is a snail roller there, the fixed 8000 HP attack, so it can be prevented by if one of our party is jump. So now let's continue the fight. Let's break this break bar or breakage on Ymir shell. Let's do triple peerless spear. Nice, and let's do the same using Mazurka. We already break it, and then for Cobalt Blade Noctis, triple ability, Omega Charge Plus, Omega Charge Plus Plus, and Return of Dawn. Same target to Ymir shell. Let's chain. Yep, we kill the shell. And then for Shoreline Vina and Daisy, let's go double C magic, Rip Current for AoE magical cover, and Sonar Healing for 8000 HP heal. Now let's revert back one of our Noctis. It seems I want to use my friend Omega for Sword Imperil to Ymir, and then for Cobalt Blade Noctis, triple ability, triple Omega Charge. So for Mazurka, let's use Lakshmi, restore HP, and then for Gilgamesh, triple hero, let's break Secret Sword at Excalibur. This is 130% of Holy Imperil. And this will boost fill LB for Shoreline Fina and Daisy. Now on turn 3, Shoreline Fina and Daisy, let's use double sea magic, special extra special sunbat, and then do we have provoke here? Yes, my provoke lasts for one turn, but I need provoke on the next turn. I think we can use the LB. Let's provoke and extra special sunbat. Another snake roller and AOE physical attack. That's the single target instant death. We already negate it. So now let's break again using Gilgamesh. Oh, for Shoreline Fina and Daisy, let's use their LB for Gilgamesh. Let's do the same. Yes. Yes, one LB. Yes, we already feel it. Let's do the same. Feeling evoke Lakshmi and then for Noctis. But Noctis jump. Warp strike and this warp strike. So if we jump, there is no snail roller here. Take all sweeps, snail fire, snail blizzard, and resist. Now we must chain using Gilgamesh and Mazurka. So let's revert back Gilgamesh to his normal form, triple try attack, the SR chain with Mazurka, triple emotional slash. So let me set up my auto cricket. Just wait a moment. Alright, let's continue SR chain. And let's wait until 300%. Let's drop Noctis 23%. That's nice. And then for now, for turn 5, let's provoke and cover. Provoke and cover. Alright, another instant death attack. So let's now back to Noctis. Let's use Mazurka this one. Recover HP, so for both Noctis jump. For Gilgamesh, I don't know what to do. Triple hero. Let's break. Feeling LB. Yes, it's good. So for Shoreline Fina and Daisy, let's use double sea magic for extra special sunbat and fill ALB gauge this one having repulse. There is no snail roller. The snail attack, tentacle pommel, another death attack. Yep, I think we kill this Ymir on this turn. Oh, they already been this Ymir already been break, but there is no Holy Imperil here. But I think it's fine. Let's use triple SR here. Triple SR, and then Holy Amplifier. Let's check. Yes, Holy Amplify already. Let's chain and drop the Noctis. Boom. Yep, we kill it in turn 7. So I think that's all for my tips for finishing this fight. So I don't know how to make another source for Holy Imperil, just because my Gilgamesh cannot change form. Yep. So if I change form, then I cannot chain with the SR chain. So I think that's all for my tips for finishing this Ymir trial. Hope you can enjoy this video, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel to support me. And I'm David from FFBE Indonesia. Bye bye.